Let's now talk to Cavite Representative Elpidio Barzaga Jr. He's the president of the National Unity Party, the second largest bloc in the lower chamber, following the ruling PDP Laban Party. Good morning, Congressman Barzaga, and thank you very much for joining us again on the program, sir.
Good morning, Christian.
We've heard the assurance coming from Speaker Cayetano that the budget would not be delayed, despite what happened at the House of Representatives. But there was this tweet coming from Senate President Tito Soto. He said, "Do not be misled. The House of Representatives has delayed the budget for a whole month. No one can ever blame the Senate for this delay. Never." Is this true?
Well, I categorically deny the statement made by Senate President Soto. Firstly, they are expecting that the budget will be submitted to them or will be approved on third and final reading. Unfortunately, that is not possible. Because under the Constitution, before we can approve the budget on the third reading, necessarily there must be printed copies of the bill, of the budget, at least three days before the date of the approval. And secondly, there must be at least 3 days interval from the second reading up to the third reading. Unfortunately, for the printing alone of the budget, it will cover a period of 2 to 3 weeks, dalawa hanggang tatlong linggo. And let me tell you the reason. First, we have 4 books of the budget. The first book consists of 1,181 pages. Then the second book consists of 1,009 pages. The third book of the budget consists of 1,254 pages. And volume 2 consists of 581 pages, or a total of 4,025 pages. And we have to print this at least 300 copies in order that each member could be given. And that cannot be done up to October 14 or 3 days before October 14, which would be October 11.
Okay.
So the Senate knows that we cannot submit the printed budget as approved on third reading on October 14, and that is a fact.
Okay.
And that was the reason why the statement of Speaker Cayetano is that if there was a delay in the budget, it will be only for 1 day. We will approve the budget on November 16. Printed copies would be available on November 16. And on November 17, the printed budget as approved on third reading will be transmitted to the Senate.
Okay, now for the benefit of our viewers, Congressman Barzaga is part of the, you are part of the committee that was formed by the Speaker, right? To accept individual amendments to the 2021 national budget. Now, in the first place, why terminate the debate and resort to a small committee to handle these amendments? Why not do it openly in plenary when the public can observe?
Well, creating small committees would be a little bit more practical, considering that we can ask the cabinet members, we can ask the individual members what would be their proposed amendments, and we can immediately act on their proposed amendments as well as the answers of the cabinet members. And to tell you honestly, Christian, this is not a new practice. This practice of creating small committees for the purpose of discussing the budget is already a procedure even during the time Congresses were existing prior to martial law.
Yeah,
this is not novel.
Yeah.
This is not new.
But you also do that. You consult with the individual departments if you follow the usual route in terms of plenary debates and individual amendments to the proposed national budget. So again, why go to this extent?
Well, of course, we have to admit the fact that there are some internal squabble insofar as the House of Representatives is concerned. And therefore, we do not want that the budget deliberation will suffer out of this internal squabble, considering that there has been already a decision on the part of the majority giving trust and confidence for Speaker Allan Peter Cayetano to continue as our House leader.
So how exactly will this squabble, let's say, affect the budget deliberations if the period of debates was not terminated and you followed the normal route?
Well, it will take a very long period of time. It is possible that there might be some interruption insofar as the budget deliberation is concerned, as what our people has been seeing in regarding the press releases of the contending parties.
But you said Speaker Cayetano has the numbers. Basically, he's in full control. So why be afraid of that?
But the trouble is that it will take time. Everybody might question a very simple item in the budget itself. You have to imagine that we are talking of the entire budget of the Philippines, And traditionally, and based on precedents, there are no individual amendments insofar as the gap is concerned. It is always a case of institutional amendments.
That's true.
Because if you would be giving each member to make a proposed individual amendment, it will take perhaps not even 1 year to complete that.
But as you've mentioned, we're talking here of the national budget. Don't the people deserve more transparency or greater transparency instead of leaving it up to a small committee to handle those amendments?
Well, the budget itself, consisting of 4,000 pages, will be printed. And the people, if they so desire, they can look on each individual items contained in 4,000 pages. Unfortunately, this is not being done even by the media itself, even by the congressmen. And that is the reality.
That's
they
true.
Some are saying from the camp of Lord Allan Peter Cayetano, from Lord Allan Velasco, that they want transparency. But I ask, have they participated actively in the deliberation of the budget prior to the closing of the debate? And the reports will bear me out.
Yeah, that's true. Not all members of the House of Representatives get to scrutinize the national budget, the proposed national budget, the nitty-gritty. You only have basically specific congressmen basically doing that. But even then, why resort to this? Why not still allow the process to be more transparent?
And it will not be even finished in October 14. On October 14.
Come again?
It will not be finished on October 14, the debate itself.
Okay.
On Tuesday, for example, I was there in the morning. The only budget being discussed is the National Bureau of Investigation. It took a couple of hours before we were able to finish the budget of the National Bureau of Investigation.
Okay.
And that is what's happening insofar as the budget deliberation is concerned. And if you are in the opposing group, you have only one tool. Interpolate, discuss, so that we can delay the approval of the budget. And that we do not want to happen.
At the end of the day, isn't this just an excuse to make sure that there won't be any showdown on October 14 and that Speaker Cayetano would be safe in his position at least until November 16?
Well, I have been reading the news. The other camp is claiming that they have already the majority. And all congressmen know that any speaker may be seated at any time. As a matter of fact, the motion to declare the position of a speaker is a priority motion. It is not a debated motion. But before you can make that motion, it necessarily follows that you must have the numbers to unseat the speaker. And therefore, they can do that anytime prior to the suspension. They can do that on November 16. They can do that on November 17 and at any time. Unfortunately, as I assess it, they don't have the numbers, although they are claiming publicly that 160 members have already supported Lord Allan Velasco.
But how about Speaker Cayetano? Does he have the numbers now?
Well, we have proven that. Number one, we have shown a manifestation of support to him signed by congressmen 202. Number two, he offered to resign and his resignation was not accepted by 189 members of the House. What proof do we need to show the public that Speaker Cayetano has the support of the overwhelming majority of the House. Insofar as the other camp is concerned, aside from saying that they have numbers, they have not shown any written manifesto or written statement signed by their alleged 160 supporters. Neither did they identify publicly who are the 160 members of the House supporting them.
But they have a list of this more than 180 House members who actually voted to reject Speaker Cayetano's offer to resign. Because one complaint is that you guys have been controlling the discussions, you have been running the show, and that certain congressmen were being muted and basically not being allowed to participate.
Well, let me state that we follow the rule of majority insofar as a working democracy is concerned. And that rule of majority is also present in the House of Representatives. Sometimes they have been referred to as the tyranny of majority. Whatever the majority wants, we would be able to approve any bill or any motion as long as there is a support coming from the majority. And that is an accepted fact in every legislature, not only in the Philippines, but even in the whole world. And of course, the opposition or the minority will always state their objection or their observations which are not in accordance with the wishes of the majority.
Yeah.
That is the basic nature of democracy. There will be always opposition. You cannot expect that there will be unanimity even if we are only 300 congressmen in the Senate. They are only 24. But you can expect, and as what we have been witnessing, there is always an opposition, the minority.
Yeah, we know that, Congressman Barzaga, as we've seen over the years, over the past several congresses. But what we saw last week was that it appeared that the offer to resign by Speaker Cayetano was part of a script. And right after that, there was an immediate rejection or motion to reject that. I mean, there was very little chance given to those who might have wanted to oppose that.
Their only opposition would be either to vote no or to abstain. Even assuming that we voted 189, and there are 300 members in the House, assuming that all the remainder, 111, would be against the Speaker, that will be only 111 votes. And therefore, the rule of the majority will prevail. The wishes of 189 for Speaker Cayetano to continue will prevail over the desire of the minority.
Who are these 189 congressmen?
But it will be stated there because it is a case of nominal voting.
Yes.
It is not age and nation.
But should the record be released to give us an idea of who exactly this congressmen are? I mean, this is an important vote, just like the vote on ABS-CBN. I don't think any official record was released regarding that.
Because this will be part of the journal of our proceedings, and the journal will state who are the 189 members who voted for Speaker Cayetano. As a matter of fact, there was only one vote registered against Speaker Cayetano. Of course, the others would be claiming that they were muted.
Now, if Speaker Cayetano indeed intended to resign, why didn't he just tender his resignation, irrevocable? Why the need for that qualification offer?
Well, number one, Christian, we know that resignation is purely a personal act. And insofar as public officials are concerned, considering that the source of power of Speaker Cayetano emanate from the members of the House, then it would be but proper that the persons, the congressmen who supported him for speakership should be consulted and should decide whether or not we have to accept the resignation. Theoretically and legally, the legal authority of Speaker Cayetano comes from the members of the House who elected him as Speaker. In the same manner that a cabinet member, he was appointed by the president in the event that he wants to resign. If the president rejects his appointment, then he cannot resign.
Okay, so this move, this motion by the speaker to terminate the period of debates or deliberations, and have the budget pass on second reading, was this not meant to avoid a showdown on October 14?
Well, I don't think so. We want to expedite the passage of the budget, and that is why a small committee was created. That a small committee would be working right now. We will accept the individual amendments or proposals of our members at the same time. At the same time, we will be making representations with the cabinet secretaries. But this small committee would not be available in the event that the budget is still the subject of deliberation in the plenary, because that would be a duplication. Normally, in most cases, when it comes to the budget deliberation, the small committee is created once the second reading has been terminated.
But how will that process be transparent? You're giving this task to a small committee to which you belong.
Well, whatever amendments that would be reflected in the budget itself, in the final, because you can see the original budget, Republic House Bill number 7727, and then you can compare it with the final version of House Bill number 7727.
Okay. Now, I'd like you to respond to this accusation coming from those who are supporting Congressman Lord Allan Velasco, that Speaker Cayetano, and of course, including yourself as an ally of Speaker Cayetano, turned away or abandoned the so-called gentleman's agreement. I mean, does word of honor still matter in the House of Representatives?
Well, if I were the political strategist of Lord Allan Velasco, my first question or inquiry is that how will the replacement or the how will Allan Velasco, Lord Allan Velasco, would be elected as a speaker. He knows for a fact that in order for him to be speaker, there must be a vote of majority of all the members of the House. It cannot just be the president cannot merely say, "Oh, Lord Allan, you are now the next speaker." But the problem is that will not be enough. They would still be a vote by the majority of the House. And second, they have been always claiming, and as you have stated before, that Lord Allan Velasco has the numbers at the time prior to the opening of the session of the Congress. But right now, if he has the numbers before, what is the reason why he does not have the numbers right now?
Well,
that's my question as a politician.
Well, because Speaker Cayetano enjoys the equity of the incumbent. He is the incumbent. So normally, you would get the support.
So in other words, the only conclusion with that, those who are supporting him initially abandoned him and did not stick to him even if there is a term sharing agreement. As a matter of fact, PDP Laban is the party where he belongs. And right now, where are the leaders of the PDP Laban? They have manifested that they are with Speaker Cayetano as shown in the manifesto of support, as shown by their votes in the rejection of the offer to resign by Speaker Cayetano.
Okay. I'd like to go back to a point that you have just made regarding the numbers that were available in favor of supposedly Speaker Cayetano last year when this gentleman's agreement was hammered out, as handled by President Rodrigo Duterte. How come the President's word was good enough for Cayetano to get the numbers last year, but not good enough now for Velasco to take over?
Well, right now, as we have seen, the President has stated, as long as you have the numbers, and if you have the numbers, if you do not have the numbers, so be it. And even the spokesman of the president has repeatedly stated that it is an internal matter on the part of the House. And as I have stated before, during our last interview, if the President would not intervene, insofar as the change in the speakership is concerned right now, then I think if there will be a vote, majority of the members of the House would be voting for Speaker Cayetano.
So as a loyal follower of President Duterte, you don't think that the words of the President regarding the need to respect the term-sharing agreement was enough to have it followed?
Well, based on my personal analysis right now, based on the statement of the President that it is an internal matter on the part of the House, and which statement was the one stated by spokesperson Harry Roque, then the President is giving leeway to all the members of the House to choose the Speaker.
So you don't see it, you don't see that as a strong enough endorsement to clinch the speakership for Velasco?
I don't think so. I do not see it that way. Based on the recent pronouncements of the spokesman of the President, even the Harry Roque has stated that the closing of the debate is an astute step on the part of Speaker Cayetano. It's a very brilliant move.
Brilliant in what sense? That he was able to...
Brilliant in the sense that we would be able to pass the budget, we would be able to discuss all the provisions by creating that small committee.
Okay. Okay, Congressman Elpidio Barzaga, thank you very much for joining us this morning, sir.
Thank you very much also, Christian.